Matrix working increases complexity, so we should only use it where it adds real value. This video will help you identify the impact of the matrix on different parts of the organisation and understand where it adds most value. We have identified three key groups within any large, complex organisation. First are the global group, the small number of leaders at the very top of the organisation who head up major business units, regions and functions, usually reporting directly to the CEO. This group will contain a very small number of people responsible for strategy and purpose. They have a critical role in leading the matrix, but are usually not matrix themselves. Second are the locally loyal, the people who have purely or very largely local jobs in shops, offices, local sales forces, and service centres. Even in highly integrated global organisations, these people are usually the vast majority of our employees, typically 85% or more of people. Though organisations with a high proportion of professional or managerial staff may have a lower percentage of the locally loyal. These are jobs where the matrix really has little relevance and only introduces complexity. Coordination of their work can be achieved through shared workflow or systems or virtual teamwork and doesn't require the complexity of multiple bosses. Try to insulate this group from the complexity of the matrix. In between sit the matrixed middle, the people in the centre of the organisation who bridge the gap between the global group and the locally loyal. Typically, no more than 10 to 15% of your employees, this group is critical to the success of your matrix. In deciding how far to go with the matrix structure, the key question is, where does this complexity add value rather than just cost and confusion? We normally recommend that dual reporting lines are only applied to the matrix middle group, and we recommend limiting the matrix to 2 or 3 reporting levels below the global group members. This, of course, is a rule of thumb, and the final design will be a function of your business realities. Other people may still be involved in matrix working across the functions and geographies, both in virtual and matrix teams and projects. We can then focus on building the skills, confidence, and capabilities of people in the global group and the matrix middle to make the matrix successful, a much more manageable task than retraining the whole organisation.